dash attack into a down tilt into a down smash, which is the safest shield pressure Lucario has, because down tilt into down smash is frame zero link. Like, on shield, it's positive almost.
Yeah.
It's exactly zero frames, you can't get out. And if you do that on crouch cancel, it breaks the down tilt can break crouch cancel.
What are Lucario's tools to stop Peach from returning to stage?
He can throw. Alright, we're getting this actually. He doesn't really have any tools.
Yeah, that's
what I'm thinking. He has to kill her, alright.
Oh, so far. He's having trouble opening up.
Alright, so an average kid's going in the way he's doing this matchup. He's not really, he's actually being super aggressive right now.
Yeah, absolutely. He's taking over the stage right now.
Trying to find a spot, but it's
got caught in his movement and got punished for it really quick here. Conrad trying to find his footing.
You know, I think the biggest problem right now for Conrad is that Peach isn't in the air. Or Peach isn't on the ground. Peach isn't in the air. Because of that, he can't really start with it.
Ooh, and that's rough. I don't know if you could have lived that with good DI, but that looked like black hole DI to me.
Okay, Mario is starting to get a grip. Nope.
Peach. He cannot find an opening. He can't spend that much time in Peach's area. It's asking for trouble.
Okay, so that was something kind of interesting that an average kid does. He thinks that in Project M, Peach's side B is a useful tool.
Okay.
I don't think they changed it. But he likes to use it, and it works. It secured the stock, but...
I think it belongs in the mix-up category.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
I definitely...
I think it's good. I don't think it's something you should rely on.
It's like me and my rocking group. It's so much better than melee. Conrad's not getting out of Peach's space. Like, he's not retreating to regroup. He's just trying to make it work. Close, he's getting hit by these disgusting down smashes. And if you were right about that, wow, he's making it work, didn't he? Yeah. First stock closed out by Conrad.
All right, see, right there he was trying to get Peach. Oh, he got it. You can charge off balloons by hitting them with aerial and canceling. And that charge leads to your aura, which is Carter's biggest combo.
Got a question. Okay, so that's fine there. It seems like a DI issue. Well, he's at 141, actually. That was a pretty good DI. I didn't realize.
Another thing, I don't know if this is... This is what I assume. I assume Conrad actually has a problem with floaties, or fighting his floaties. Oh, we got the beam sword.
I don't think...
I swear to God, an average kid gets a beam sword every game.
It's for throwing, dude. It's for throwing. So powerful being thrown. Oh, he accidentally picked it up. He would have been hit by that down smash. Beam sword canceled the first down smash, and then the second one came out after he picked it up. You, of course, pick up items from the C-Stick, which can lead to a lot of trouble.
Oh, there you go.
If he throws it again and it hits...
No, it's looking pretty different. Yeah,
looking pretty rough for Gwendolyn.
Okay.
Three solid stocks. Conrad not being able to be the flexible man that we all thought he could be.
One character down for Quinn's team, and
so now we have the choice of Lee Marth. We can send in a Meta Knight, or we can send in a Bowser.
The Marth sounds like the best idea.
It does, but it requires... it's me, so I'm going to have to see what I have to do. But I have to play just a very patient game and avoid and stuff the rush down, which I think I can do. But can I do it and bring our lead back? Three stocks without losing one?
Another thing you're going to have to remember here is that he's playing hyper-aggressive right now.
Yeah.
He's going in. He does not get. And that's something, no matter who goes in, they're going to have to account for.
Mm-hmm. I agree. All right. We chose our stock tank.
We brought in Quinn. Yeah, you know, that's actually interesting because now they can't counterpick Quinn for me. So as soon as I go in, I don't think anyone's gonna be able to come out.
I can.
Yeah, probably.
Depends on the match.
True.
I'm the only one who knows how to stop your garbage.
you're really the only one that can count me out now. But I have gotten a lot of experience in the Marth matchup.
Yeah.
My only Marth here that actually is dominant against me right now is not even dominant. Me and Raven can go back and forth. But he knows how to taper me off of every type of throw, and it's awful. Because he'll DMX at me to where it's like 20%, but it guarantees a tipper, and then he'll send me out and he'll just guard me and can't come back.
Gotcha.
But I don't know. I have a good grasp on that. Alright, so now Bowser versus Peach.
Bowser versus Peach.
Down smash.
Quinlan, the way he plays, just as a tank in this game, he really takes a lot of damage, but boy, does he develop the harshness.
The problem here, though, is that as soon as Quinn gets in the air, he can't do much. He can try to nair, which has armor on it, but, Peach is good both on the ground with the down smash and with her aerials. So, if Peach can get first hit, this is very hard for Bowser.
And Yeah, Bowser's already in a troubled situation. Now Peach is starting up a little bit of camping, grabbing some turnips, and choosing her spots, and now it's really bad.
Okay.
Quinn gets in now. Big damage. Couldn't finish it.
That was a decent risk. Honestly, Quinn, when Quinn has stage control, he's very, very good at keeping his stage control. So
ends up taking the first stocks. Definitely doesn't look like it's going to be the humongous moving comeback. Definitely going to have to lose something here. I'm really impressed that he's alive. But there it goes.
All right, 140% up air kill.
140%. But he found, you know what? He found his point almost all at once. All of his damage came at almost the same time. So if he maybe got a read or is kind of now comfortable in the seat, he might be able to hold his back.
Oh, one thing about Quinn, loves the flame. I don't know why. He thinks the flame is really good. I mean, it's not bad.
It's free damage. When you really get it, if you can get it, if you have a decent range, it's free damage.
If you're spaced properly,
you can get it. And you're forcing them to do kind of fall out of their groove and, like, smash the eye out.
Nice. Okay, actually, here, this is...
Nice grab.
This is very good for
Yeah, Quinn looks like he definitely got a grasp on that rushdown that... Average Kid was doing early. And see, look at, he's making, Average Kid is smash DI again.
Because Average Kid wants to crush Kid's down smash it.
Yeah, but throwing off his groove. It's good damage, it's free damage.
Yeah.
I like it.
Another thing I saw in Average Kid doing about probably 45 seconds ago, he likes to use the down B too. He likes to use Peach's whole kick, which is kind of weird, but it works for him. It doesn't seem to be working right now. Okay, just gonna try.
Quinlan needs to close his stock out soon, otherwise Average Kid will have taken
this situation out. Take that position until he dies. Never mind. Koopa Fall.
Clean edge guard. Oh, I like it. Kills the jump.
He's going to have tilt after this.
Clean. So, okay. Nice job, Quinlan, grasping that our crew battle effort.
They're only down,
one,
stock.
One stock now.
look at him. He's
an interesting thing right now would be to put LSD in off the front. Oh, I called it. Did I not call it?
Well, yeah, that was our plan. The only Quinn counter really have is LSD, because I cannot play Quinn.
Yeah.
I can't do it.
Snake, he's definitely going to do work keeping Bowser out. To be fair, if he takes about two stocks here, we're going to have our hope kind of back kindled. But if it's a shutout... Really? I did not know that. I do know Quinn is the... tremendous player, and he's really quick at adapting. Actually,
he
played friendlies for about 3 or 4 hours, so I adapted to his style. I ended up taking like 4 games in a row, and then he got a drink, he stepped outside, got cooled down. He came back in, he made all the correct adjustments, and just got me right back.
Another thing is, he likes to pick up a new character like every 2 weeks, and when he plays that character, he can win, he can beat me, but he does it specifically by adapting to what I do. Like he's just a very smart player.
Yep.
But here we go, LSD.
The weaknesses of Bowser are showing through this very moment.
I feel like if he played another character, like, primarily, he could place a little bit better, because Bowser does have some inherent weaknesses, but he also uses Bowser's, like, strengths very well. His crouch cancel, his up B out of shield.
Yep.
That's frame 3, I think you told me.
Okay. There we go. Finally getting in. Very conscious of the explosives. A lot of people are. Even, like, Moy's like Bane against LSD. Does not understand how the explosives work.
Okay, so there was Quinn trying to get the Koopa Claw again, probably to back throw, but he got the hit up and like the sticky. It's just pretty punished.
Yeah,
around 80%, I think, if he gets a decent hit off of mine and then sticky. Snake's very good against Bowser in the sense that it's very easy for him to like start stuff on him because he's so big, but neutral, it does be pretty awkward. It's a lot of bad.
Yeah, a lot.
I really don't know how to describe the matchup.
LSD doesn't play the matchup. I think I normally see it. He's gotten actually a little more standardized in his...
He's been doing that all day today. LSD, he's been reloading.
He's been doing that all of his life. I can tell you from like a year ago. He did it then. It hasn't changed. It's like his worst.
I've seen him do it 3 times a day, though.
Oh, wow. Yeah, that's pretty bad. I've seen him do it in, like, Winner's Finals to lose the last stock, so,
Alright, and, there's spacing on the fire, but it doesn't matter, because...
Okay, I'm hoping for Quinn to take at least one more stock.
I'm hoping for him not to.
I know you are, yeah. I'm so scared.
Okay.
It's really hard to pin down what he should be doing, because... because mostly, as turns out, like most of the big damage from LSD comes from his grab. Like,
right. Well, this whole matchup for LSD is just trying to stick him.
Yep.
So grabbing is usually the best way to do it. Okay. Quinn probably has edge guard here. Or not. No.
Very hard to edge guard.
I'm so used to Quinn edge guarding me that I always expect something to happen.
I mean, Snake, one of the few characters who can recover at any height and be actionable after recovery.
Very,
so
very
it gives him infinite
health. Oh, the down air chain.
Beautiful. Beautiful
claw. Oh,
couldn't convert anything out of it, though. It looked like a starter of something real good.
When he up threw him there, I thought he was going to go for a sticky in the air. Because I've seen him do that at least once this match, and it worked. Oh, that was interesting.
Oh.
Oh, he didn't get the grab.
It was rough because, it wasn't good enough to get the full damage. He was only at like 30, so he couldn't just go right into smash and hope that was good enough. Real shame.
I think LSD's starting to get worried.
He's definitely playing a little different.
He's less aggressive. And he's strange.
He's not getting into the groove where he can get those grabs anymore. He's actually keeping his spacing distance because he's trying to keep stocks, which subsequently is losing him stocks.
Ooh, okay. This is very interesting. Just needs to get one good hit here. Or that.
That's it.
There we go.
Got him down to one stock, though.
Let's see who they're throwing against Snake now.
Most interesting. Very likely me, but it wouldn't be a bad idea to throw Meta Knight in.
No, it wouldn't.
Meta Knight keeps off the ground. The question is,
who play Meta Knight?
Vandyre.
Vandyre.
Can Vandyre have the... And I played it. Half decent. Really was. Can Vandyre have the awareness to avoid explosives? That is a hard question. Looks like... We got one more player. Here's... playing, actually. He's going in. I completely forgot. My brain. My poor little brain.
I have no idea.
Well, we'll both
now,
excited.
Whoever goes in next, you always have like one stop from LSD.
Yeah.
And that's the biggest thing here. It could be a... is it dead? Oh, it's dead.
The roughest part is you want to take one stock, so you want to go in thinking about the next step, right? So you put in a character you think is going to do well getting countered against. But if you don't think well enough against this pick, you will lose stocks to Snake before you can get on to the next guy.
Yeah.
And
I
think Dad's going to be here.
Dad's definitely going to do it. But Dad's very interesting.
Showtime.
He plays Wario, right? And he plays pretty much everyone, to be honest. But he plays Wario in turn. He's gotten very good recently. Very good. Like, kind of worrisome.
Worrisome how good he's gotten.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Beautiful!
I told you.
Dad!
I'm gonna assume that I have to go up now, so I'm speaking up.
Hey, hold up till they flag you. So.
Oh my god. Yeah, Dad.
What is your strategy against Dad if you go in?
Against Dad, personally? I don't know. I'm just gonna do it.
You're just gonna do it?
Because like he's Wario. I used to down throw his Wario jab reset, and he wouldn't be able to tech it. And I would just abuse that a lot. But then all of a sudden...
He started...
Yeah, I'm going on. I know.
Yeah, you're send someone my way. you were keeping it in the crew. Are you in that crew? Are you in LSD's crew?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, yeah. Grab it up. Welcome.
Oh, my God.
Good crew so far. Even bout.
It's gone pretty much exactly as expected.
Actually, no. I honestly... I surprised Quindlen came back. What I expected was Quinn to actually lose, not take as much from LSD.
No, I thought he was going to go 1-2 stock down to that.
Yeah.
Dad? Oh, okay, actually, right. The dad finishing
dad,
off
dad
instant,
finishing off
that was a little unexpected.
Quality.
But me and Bicycle are over there calling it out. I'm like, okay, so this is going to happen, then we're going to send in Rob.
Okay.
And then, you're out. Yeah. Don't tell any... You're not out. Okay, never mind.
I'm not out.
Never mind.
I'm on the other team, too, so you can't.
Yeah, that's fine.
You can't,
Plus, I'm not captain, so.
I mean, I'm just gonna be sitting here. You could tell me that, because I'm just gonna be sitting here with you enjoying this fine battle.
Okay, so. Who do you think's got this?
One! Go!
Okay, so Rob M actually said, I don't know what to do with this dude. So.
See?
Yeah, that's not a secret.
Yeah, that's no secret. We were worried about Dad the most. Almost as much as Quinn, because. Quinn, LSD can take.
Right.
It's going to be a hard effort, but Dad has been killing LSD.
What Rob said, Robin, is you used to have answers for Dad, and then Dad got freakishly good and worries him.
Yeah. Because he's had to go Roy, and he can't do that with a character lock. So the only way Rob's going to win is if he outchanks him. but they've been playing too much lately, so.
Yep. I like the cautious play from Rob, not jumping right back on the stage. Taking his time. If you set the pace, I think you can beat Wario, because I think Wario runs off a lot of momentum. A lot of his crap rolls into like, other things that he does. If you can just slow him down and make him have to reset the situation, you get away with it better.
Oh, too hard of a read.
The hardest of these. Down smash would have been better. That would have covered three options, but he decided to cover only one.
I like that.
Oh.
The flubs.
Yep. So, Rob, I'm counting stars right now. Dad just threw that one right out of the window.
As long as it's even, I want it to go down really close, because me or Tal might be able to take off the last stop.
I could see it going close. Close is actually, because, like, yeah, you've been losing to Dad, but...
No, not at all. The problem is, I don't play against Wario.
And then what we have left is, I think we'll probably throw it. I think I'm the closer. I think we're throwing it in.
I think it's gonna be you against me, man.
It's never gone good for you.
I know.
I'm glad. I was afraid that I was actually going to have to be the one who shut down LST. Clint was going to save himself for closer, but I like that. I like how it went. I'm happy.
I like how it's going.
I like how it went.
It's not a sure thing, but there's hope for both sides.
Oh, wow. Really tight.
The cutter. He's going for some fast out-of-ledge options there. Good reads.
Yeah, Rob M is not getting impatient about this last stock. I like that. He knows he has to close it out, but he's not running too hard. He ends up finding it open and goes, cool, I like it. No, he's not on my team, but he's got to call it out. Yep. Good play. Smart play.
Actually, I just want
it's actually just DM. Really good DM.
No.
I was gonna say there's no shutouts.
He should not be going for the Kirby side.
No, he shouldn't be going for the Kirby side.
It's not gonna work on Dad.
And you know what? His neutral will be winning. Oh, Dad calls. That's one of the scariest things. Is that side B? I think it's one of the most dangerous in this game. Is that side B?
So, all it is a question of whether Rob can get one more stock off. Because I think we're gonna send in Tal after.
Thanks. I don't think so. I mean, look at even percent so far. Dad's lost the stock to himself and Wonder.
Does he have the Waft Charge?
He doesn't have Waft Charge.
He's getting close though.
Rob actually. Oh yeah, look at him.
I like the nair.
Seal it out. And yeah, he falls into the jank.
There's the Waft. Oh boy.
I told you.
Oh boy.
You got it. You called me. Sent out. Okay, so now Tao's going in.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, my hands are starting to freeze.
Oh, yeah.
You shouldn't have said anything, man. Hey, I'm playing against you now.
Yeah, okay, so they're sending in Tao, arguably.
Yeah.
I mean, Tao seems not happy about it. Look at
Tao is really, really unhappy about it. But Tao plays against Dylan more than I do. It's okay.
Look at that 2-liter. Oh, wow, dude, he's living that Wario life. Look at that 2-liter.
I know.
He's putting it down. Does he drink a whole 2-liter?
Every time he comes here.
Wow. He's charging his waff, bro.
Oh. Why?
They're putting you in.
That's such a bad idea.
They're putting you in.
Should have played Jimmy, because he plays more against Dylan. Okay.
I don't even play this fucking game.
Yeah, you're not neither.
What's up, guys? It's Taco fucking Tuesday with.
Yeah, we're putting the cruise on. Give it to.
This game sucks.
Yeah, give it to Con.
Fuck out of here.
Oh, Connor. What's
going on, guys?
All right, so Dad definitely just helped our crew.
Brought it back, yeah, for sure.
Yeah, and now for the first time in the crew, we are in the lead and substantially two stocks.
Alright.
Yep. Man, that was a bad idea not asking for a warm-up. Oh my god.
I'm already, you see this? I'm already like, hands are cold? Okay, got it.
Yeah, I should have just played with my controller a bit. Yeah, Dad, like I said, I used to be able to beat him really easily. And then he got really good.
Noon did not want to be where he is right now. Noon thought he understood the whole meta of this crew battle. but he is not too confident going in against Dad either.
Who's left on your team, Van Dyer?
Van Dyer and me.
Okay.
Yeah. So I'm starting to wonder if I even need to give up. Am I going to be commentating for the rest of this set?
You're commentating for the crew battle. That
for
is your role.
The entirety of the crew battle, I will be commentating because I think Dad is about to go sweeping the halls out.
I can see
so
it.
So there's a dirty Lucario, there's a dirty Ivysaur, and we're done. We're out of here.
The
in between matches, tell them the random
bird. Oh, with the crew battle at oh my god. Okay, so I live
for starting. Hold it up. Okay, go ahead, go ahead. Oh, we're starting.
Oh yeah.
Hold it up.
I'll say after this.
One, go.
All right, so Dad, yeah, he likes to do that right off the beginning. Oh, I think this is Hanwha. This is Hanwha. Okay, so I live like 45 minutes away from here, right?
Yep.
And then occasionally I bring like two or three guys, very sporadically. Like I brought my friend Zach today, who's mainly. He's getting in melee. Anyway, so I live 45 minutes away. A lot of my friends that play Smash, I met here, right?
What direction 45 minutes?
I live in St. Charles.
Okay,
so that's
so
like, you know, I just kind of GPS my way here.
I live south. I live north.
Yeah, I think. So bad direction.
Do you go through Chicago?
No.
Okay.
I just halfway between me and Chicago.
Okay. Then we live next to each other.
Oh really?
Yes. Good to know. All right, sorry I ruined your story, quite frankly.
I'll finish
it. But this crew battle is starting up. I'm sorry to hold geography and all this.
All right, so Noon's been improving a lot.
Noon has been improving, but I think he has a lot of fatal weaknesses. I think he goes in too much. I don't think he reads what the opponent's doing. I think Noon plays Noon's game, and if Noon's game doesn't work, Noon gets moved on.
One thing, though, Noon does the Noon, which might work, because Wario doesn't really have that much of a mix-up on his recovery. Oh, that was.
Wow.
Okay, so if that hits a shield, the frame it comes out, it just kind of bounces in the random direction. It doesn't actually power shield. And that was that.
Yeah.
And he's dead.
He's dead. And.
Alright,
Lucario can go to stock.
Yeah,
I believe Noon can kick the stock out of here, unless he's doing stuff like that.
Noon needs to either grab, down throw, and then nair him, or down tilt nair him. Because if he gets any more. Yeah, or side. Okay,
go.
I was gonna say, any more percent, and it would be very hard to get a secure kill off it.
Alright, in a perfect world for your team, Noon takes this.
Yes,
but
right.
I do not think it's likely.
Okay, not with that. Not with that either.
Not with stuff like that.
Okay, well, he has two stocks to do this. I think he can. He's taking a breath. He's taking a breather up there. Alright, what Noon needs to do right now is not. Oh, that's very interesting.
Beautiful.
Like a lot that. Of Noon's choices are confusing to me.
Noon only has a few approach options, and I think he's nervous right now. This is actually more nerve-wracking than Bracket. I don't know how many injuries you've done, but I never perform like optimally when our crew isn't beat up by like real like performance. I never.
Oh yeah,
because it's the most nerve-wracking thing. To
I beat Dad yesterday in Bracket. Like
yeah, you could play for yourself.
I just
play for other people. You immediately get more nervous. Nuts. So,
all right. So Noon.
Noon's
I just want to see him do his typical thing where he hits a dash attack, up tilts, and then like forward airs him. Because that's like the only thing I can see him doing right now that would work. But he has to not get hit by Wario.
And not, he just got hit by Wario. Noon looking like his last stock in this tournament. The Roblox tournament. I guess it's round robin, so your team would still get to play the other.
It's not. It's
like it, elimination. Oh, okay, this looks like Noon's last stock in this crew tournament.
Wait, there's no losers? Okay.
Oh,
man,
wow.
I wish I performed a little better.
Beautiful 3-egg combo.
Oh, this could be it.
That could be
this
the
could
one
be
chance. Did not capitalize.
He
let him have the stage.
He almost got the nair, though. That was his goal.
He backed up. Yeah, he wanted him to come on stage and, like, bait him into something.
And Noon's dead.
And that's it.
All right.
Dad is sweeping.
Well, you know, okay, so the story.
Yes.
All right, so anyway, I had some guys from here come to my friend's house. They all drove up, and then we had a crew battle, right?
Yeah.
We drafted teams like normal. Dad, we didn't have like normal crew battle rules because we didn't know like how random worked. So Dad went random. He swept through three people, I think. Three people playing random. He got Fox and he up smashed my friend four times to secure the stock. He was juggling people with up smashes as Fox. It was ridiculous. The thing about random is you can't counterpick it.
Yeah.
So he just swept through everyone and ended up winning the game. And then it got down to the last guy from both teams. Because his team was originally down 3-9. And then it just went through everyone.
So,
Dad is very good at crew battles.
Is very good at crew battles, and I could say now, so we have Vandyre and me still. I confidently could have beaten him. I have beaten Kyle here.
Look at that, he's taunting. Look at his face.
Yeah, I can in fact beat Kyle here. Vandyre's still to go in too, so like...
Yeah, I don't kind of. Tao needs to really, really get his groove.
It's good to see Tao smiling and not like looking nervous as hell. Yeah. So there's hope.
This is Dad's third game.
Dad was more than an MVP in this game. He just kind of started sweeping.
You know what I want? Did I leave Dad with one stock? Or did I leave Dad with two stocks? I left him with two stocks.
He left with two stocks. I'm sorry. And this is his last stock. How many do you think Dad could get away with? I think realistically, he can get away with two. I don't think he can get away with three. I think
it's Dad, and I think he's going to hit a side beam, and I think that's going to be like the last time.
He's actually sharp enough to. He has some really smart, like, defensive setups.
He is all about. Currently, he tries to play all about space.
Yeah.
And it can work until people get in.
And then he gets punished, yeah.
Yeah, he gets punished pretty bad. But that's just because he also plays Ivysaur, and Ivysaur does this, so the best defense outside of space.
Poor choice, but able to get back with Tether because Ivysaur is amazing recovery.
Now, one thing Dad does is he loves platforms. He retreats to the top platform whenever a new stock, like right there. He's just going to stand on the top platform and then hide. See?
Yeah.
And Tao needs people to be on the ground so he can put the Razor Leaf into a crab.
Right.
If he stays on platforms, Dad is...
So him not picking... Him not picking Smashville was pretty unique. I think that in the bottom row that we're working with, I think Smashville is...
I was told we're supposed to hit random for the...
Oh, we're supposed to hit random. That's why this is happening. Okay. I actually wasn't aware, no.
Yeah, I'm thinking, if I could choose, I would not have gone to Yoshi's against Wario.
Fair point. Yeah, I didn't think about that at all. Yeah. I'm more familiar with, like, melee crew battles in that sense. So, like...
Oh!
He used his waft, and Tao did not see that coming. He thought that was the end of the recovery. He ended up getting off ledge. Non-familiarity with the character.
If there's one thing Tao does know really well, he knows how to actually get the tether. Like, I don't know how he hits the tethers.
Oh, jumps right. So this is where I think the line is. This is, I think, as much as Dad can get away from within reason. I'm waiting to be impressed. I'm so far very impressed with Dad, so
that is a kill percent. I don't know what move Ivysaur can like easily land though on a warrior.
Oh, like that was gorgeous.
Shoot. What
back air? I think he can
back air. I don't think that'll kill Wario though.
Think when Wario's off stage, he needs to be aggressive off stage.
Yes.
If he's not aggressive off stage.
Oh, you got the nair. Oh, I was expecting up smash.
Okay, he's just trying to hold ledge, and Wario, like, with the way he recovers, and specifically Dad, he's getting away with just getting the ledge back every time. Oh, that was such a risky commitment. This might be it for Dad. Uses his waft again, and Tao didn't recognize it. Gets that magnet hand, dude.
Come
magnet
on.
Hands.
Dad, stop.
Now Dad is reaching. Now Dad just
Dad
is getting
not
greedy.
Well, Dad wants to get one more stock.
Yeah.
He definitely does. He's also at a percent. I'm not sure if this is true, but Tao Tao has told me that Ivysaur suffers from Marth syndrome.
Can't back kill at high percents, yeah.
Back
that's
throw.
It?
There we go.
Arthritis.
There we go.
All right, I think we're putting in Vans now. Yeah, Vandyre already unwrapping his controller. Dad, nice performance. How many stocks? Let's count the stocks.
Okay, so he took
the last
four
one
for me.
He cleaned up LSD's last stock.
So that's five,
four,
plus the two he just took.
And two he just took.
That was seven stocks.
Seven stocks.
Wow.
Nice performance from Dad.
Yes.
Tao is the last person, and I'm still on the couch.
I think Tao can take out Vandyre. Because I think
he can take out Vandyre.
If he
but I don't
Razor
think
Leaf.
He can take out Vandyre on his stock count.
True.
I think he will outplay Vandyre in the game, but I do not believe that he will beat Vandyre with this stock count. That is my opinion.
Oh, it's Meta Knight. I forgot it's not Roar.
It is Meta Knight. So that is a lot of survivability. The thing about it, though, is I think he can exploit Meta Knight being in the air a lot. I think the way I've seen him play is Ivysaur, but we'll see.
This is
I like this pick too, because now his Razor Leaf setups are going to work. I guess it's random, but, you know, in his favor. So when he starts doing those Razor Leaf setups, he can get in on
it. Yeah, because Meta Knight has nowhere to hide except for the platform.
And right, and that platform's not always available.
No, but plus Tao can just back air, and he'll hit the platform, and he's safe.
Right, and yeah, low platform, very dangerous. I feel like Ivysaur.
So how long has he been playing Meta Knight? Because recovering with Meta Knight is such a finicky like issue.
I think he's been playing it for about a month.
Okay.
So and you know what? In our play, he never died from a fraudulent recovery.
Okay.
He died from neutral. So I'm more worried about his neutral.
3, 2, 1. Here we go. Go. Yep, he starts out with the Razor Leaf Nairs like he likes to do.
Yep.
Okay. One thing though. Tartar was telling me how the thing that beats that is Crouch Cancel. And Meta Knight, amazing at Crouch Cancel. His down tilt comes out very fast.
I do not know if Vandar is aware about that. I've never in my time playing Vandar seen him have really good Crouch Cancel setup.
Yeah, I don't think he's good. He's definitely not Crouch Cancel.
And nice opening from Tao. Tao reaching a little bit there. I think he wanted to turn that around.
He tends to go for the upbeat. He likes to reverse the upbeat if he can't get it, but he often. I don't see him reverse it too often.
Oh, Vanda trying to
get
there.
That was a good back air.
Tao gets back.
Covering his options with Razor Leaf. One back air should kill him. Or not. There we go. Yeah,
okay,
one back.
First stock. You get a little healing in, trying to push Solar Beam, but I think Vandar's gonna be able to sneak the stock out right after that. Yeah. Is he gonna be aggressive?
He will get the tether. Yeah, I don't think Vandar's gonna
get a go off stage. He could go off stage if all characters any Meta Knight. One of
Meta Knight's downer is amazing game for.
Yeah.
It hits out if you're the
And his up air chases are pretty immaculate. You gotta be willing to do it and good enough to do it. So I actually, if Vandar doesn't feel comfortable doing it, I totally agree with just staying on stage. As opposed to just, you know, flailing.
Man, it is so cool. Let me check my phone. This is awesome.
So I have no on?
I didn't think so. I thought I would be inside in a warm room.
Snare? Can he finish it off?
It's 50 degrees out.
And that's
down,
one
yeah,
stock.
Yeah, crouch cancel down smash, that's very good for Meta Knight.
LSD's crew on their final stock. Ooh, I don't know why, that low percent, that didn't seem good. It was such a risk. He put himself by the ledge and everything, so don't do it, man.
Ooh, he got the balloon in it too. That's a true combo, did you know?
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, balloon pop to kill.
See? Yeah. Vandar didn't tilt his fly down. So yeah, that would be the inexperienced recovery. He could have tilted his fly down and gone under the level. He could have done anything at that point. He had all of the options, but he thought about
Vandar's gonna rush in here. Or not. Okay.
Nice patience. He stayed at the right range too for his jab combo. And then how
I think he used both of his jumps to align the Razor Leaf. He didn't realize it.
Well, I have yet to touch my controller whilst plugged in.
So
I'm gonna stand up.
I'm gonna
commentate the next set because I think I'm good luck.
Yeah, definitely.
Hopefully you don't have to go twice.